Friends, welcome to Java training session 45. This is Haradhan once again to let you know the Java collection framework Hashtable. So what is Hashtable? Java Hashtable class implements a Hashtable, okay, which maps keys to value, inherit dictionary class and implements the map interface. A Hashtable is an array of a list. Each list of the array is known as a bucket. The position of the bucket is identified by calling the hash code method. A hash table contains values based on the key, right? So here in the diagram, I already showed an example, right? Hash table, you need to pass the two thing, right? One is the key, first one is the key, second one is the values. It can be integer string, it can be integer, it can be string, it can be string integer. Then you need to create the object or instance, new hash tables, and then the data type you need to pass it for keys and values. Hashtable basically data structure which holds some information along with the reference number. So for each and every reference there will be some hash code, okay. Hashtable store key or value pair in the hashtable, okay. So each pair will be stored in the hashtable. Pair means keys and value. So here you can see, right, this is the key and this is the value, okay. So I am just putting some data into the hash tables and I want to print the keys and value. That's why that is the syntax. Now I will show you what are the different methods or functions available in the collection framework for the hash table. So using the hash table, right, through keys and through values, we can add some data. So I have created a project, Java Training Session 45. So I want to give an example, right? Suppose student roll number. Student and roll number, right? So my student roll number will be the keys and student name will be, okay, the values, right, for any school, colleges. So corresponding to roll number, like there will be a one student, okay. So my keys should be unique and my student name can be duplicate, so my values can be duplicate. So what is the syntax for creating the hash table? HASH hash table, then you need to give the right data type for keys and values. Suppose here as the keys will be my roll number, right, roll number, so it will be integer. Then as the values will be name, so it will be string. Then I need to give the object or instance name, whatever I am going to create for the hash table. Suppose each table, okay, I'm giving it. Then you need to use the new keyword for creating a new hash tables, okay. Then you need to give the same thing, hash table and reference for, right, data type for keys and values. Then you need to close with first bracket, okay. So it is creating. Still error message is there. So you need to import the Hashtable class from Java Tutorial package. So once the import is successful, right, so error message will gone and now I can add more data, right. What is the syntax? What is the method for adding data? Syntax is put dot, sorry, I mean we need to give the object Hashtable dot put and we need to give the reference here, right. Suppose I want to give the reference as 1, okay, and the name, suppose James, okay, and I need to close with semicolon. Similarly I can add more data, okay. Suppose I want to add 4 data. Suppose roll number is 5, say, and name is suppose John, and roll number is suppose 3, okay, and name is suppose Sharon, and roll number is suppose 10, okay, and name is suppose Williams, say, okay. So I am adding 4 different values to the hash table. So before adding, if I want to check whether my hash tables is empty or not, so how can I check it? You need to give the object reference here dot is empty, right. Similarly after adding the value you can check also whether your hash table is empty or not, okay. And you can put, I mean you can print all the data, right. So you need to give the hash tables here. So let's run the code. So I am creating the hash tables. My object is hash tables, okay. Then I want to check whether hash table is empty. Before, obviously it will be empty before adding the data, then I have adding the data, right? And I am checking whether again it's empty or not, and I am printing all the values. Okay, you can see first it is true because it is obviously empty. After adding the data, it is not empty, and I am getting the values, right? Okay, so I mean the value is coming on the descending order. Okay, 10 is Williamson, 5 is John, 3 is Sharon, and 1 is James. Okay, it is not based on the insertion order, or it is not coming as randomly. So it is coming in descending order, right? Based on the key, whatever I have given. Okay, now if you want to get all the values, right, in the right set format, so what is the syntax? SYSO, you need to give the reference of the object dot keyset. Sorry, keyset, right? So it will give you the details in the, I mean, give you the keyset only, right? All the keys, okay? You can see it's coming all the key. Similarly, if you want to print all the, right, all the values only, so what is the syntax? It will be values, Hashtable dot values, right? You can check, it will display you all the values. Through key set, you can get all the values, sorry, all the keys, and through values, you can get all the values, right? It is coming based on the asset descending order. Williamson is coming first, then John, then Sharon, right? And then James. Suppose if you want to get printed in the set format, so how can you get it? SYSO as tables dot entry set, that method you need to use it, so you will get it in the set format. Okay, so if you run it, you can see it's coming in the set format. Okay, right, in the descending order. Okay, 10 Williams, 5 Johns, 3 Aaron, 1 James. Now you want to get all the values and key, right, at the same time, so you need to use an ends for loop, right? So what is the syntax for? You need to declare a variable type, right, for as the my key is integer, so it will be integer, right, integer, then you need to define an integer I, right, then you need to give the colon, then reference number for the object dot key set. Okay, then you need to print all the keys and values, right? So I will print first the keys, which will be my I, right? Then I'm giving some S here, then what will another will be object dot get of I. So it will give me all the objects. Okay, so what the problem is there for integer key set? SYSO, I am going to print it. Get of I, here some problem is coming. So enhance for loop is no need to use the forward. Okay, so here what is the problem? To close with this syntax, syntax here. Okay, so for will be outside. Okay, enhance for loop, for will be outside. So you can see error message gone. So for integer I, then hash tables, then key set, and I want to print all the keys and all the values. So if you run it, you can see it will be coming in different line. Okay, okay, right, with the descending order. Okay, if you want to print only write the keys, you need to simply print it. Right, the keys, only it will print you the keys in the different line, in the descending order, right? If you want to get the values only, so Hashtable dot values, right? Different line format, okay? You can see some error message is coming because values is string, so you need to change it to string. Okay, if you change it to string, you can see error message gone. Okay, you can get the values in the descending order based on the keys, right? Now, if you want to get for a particular right keys, so how can you get it? Okay, you need to give the reference as table of the object dot get, right? You need to pass it the primary key. Suppose I want to get the value for roll number 3, the name I want to get it, right? If you run it, you can see only the name for roll number 3 will be Sharon will be coming, right? Okay, it is coming, right? Now if you want to remove a particular value, how you can remove it? Remove, right? Okay, now if you need to give the reference, suppose I want to remove the roll number 10 from the hash table, okay, and the name also. So once we are removing the key, automatically associated values will be removed. Okay, now if you want to print all this thing, just simply you need to print it, right? So you can see that particular name will not be there, right? Roll number 10 and name is not there. So it John, Sharon is one, James is coming in the descending order, okay? Now if you want to update some value, dot replace, that particular method or function you need to use it. Suppose I want to update the value for Sharon, okay, 3, you need to give the roll number 3 here and you need to give the updated name, suppose Aaron, instead of Sharon it will be Aaron, okay. Now if you run the code, you can see the updated value will be coming here, okay. You can see updated value is coming here, right? Okay. Now, if you want to validate whether my keys is containing a particular word or my values is containing a particular word, so how can you do it? You need to simply use the SYSO method. Then you need to give the object or reference, object reference, then is contents, right? Contents. Here contents key or contents value. Suppose I want to check contents key and here I am giving keys as suppose 10. Okay. So if you run it, you can see 10 is present here. So it will be obviously true, right? Okay. And the value, all value is coming. And if you want to check anything which is not valid, suppose 13, right? Obviously it will be false. Okay. Because this is that particular key is not here, so it will be coming as false. Now, if you want to check whether any particular value is available or not in the hash table, so dot contents value, right? So here you need to give some value. Suppose I want to verify whether John is present or not. Okay, so you can see it will be coming as true, right? So all the value is coming. Williams, Sharon, John, Sarah, I mean James is coming. Now if you want to check Aaron, whether Aaron is present, okay, because Aaron is not present, so it will be obviously give you the false. Okay, you can see. Now another method or functions which is very important in the hash table. Suppose if you want to clear all the values, right, in the hash tables, how can you do it? So what is the syntax? Object dot clear, there is a clear method, okay, so it will clear all the values in the hash tables though you have added it. So now after clearing it, let's try to check it, the different value. So after adding, I am just checking it, okay. After clearing it, I want to check it again. So if you run it, you can see, right, before clearing, so all the values is coming in the descending order: Williams, John, Sharon and James. After clearing, no value is present, keys and values. So it is blank set, it's coming, right? Okay, so that's how you can clear everything. Now, if you want to create another hash table, right? So what is the syntax? Syntax, same syntax, suppose I am giving the name as Hashtable 1. Okay, and then now I want to clone all the right entities to my Hashtable. Okay, so how can I do it? Right, I have created another Hashtables. So here I want to clone the existing one, Hashtables 1, right? So after adding the data, I will clone it. Otherwise, there will be no meaning. Okay. So first, I am adding the data to my Hashtable 1, which is Hashtables, and then I want to clone, right, the data of first Hashtable into the second Hashtables equal to. Okay. Then I need to give the Hashtable reference for the first Hashtables, right? Hashtable 1 equal to this, you need to close it with bracket. Okay, then the reference number, then here you need to press enter dot and then clone. Okay, so it will be automatically clone. So all that details from the Hashtable 1 will be cloned to Hashtable, this Hashtable. Okay. Now, if you want to print it, SOISO, okay, Hashtable 1, instead of Hashtable, I already cloned all the data from this to this, okay. Now, I want to validate whether the data is being reflected or not, so just I will print it, all these values, right. You can see, all the data is coming here, because all the data is getting already cloned, okay. So, before cloning, if you want to validate it, so it will be simply blank, right? Before cloning, if you want to validate it, let's run it. Because there is no data, right? You can see it's blank set. And after cloning, it's the thing is coming, right? Another important thing I want to show you, right? The hash code. How you will get the hash code for each hash tables? Okay, because every hash table will have some corresponding hash code, right? Need to give the object of reference, then hash code. Okay, so you will get the hash code. So the hash code will returns you using the hash code method. You can get the hash code value for this map as per the description in the map interface available. Okay, so that is the importance of hash code method in the collection framework for the hash tables, right? You can see, right, some code is getting generated, okay? So, that are the different important functionality for the hash table. You can create multiple hash tables. You can check whether the hash table is empty or not. You can add more data for different data type, right? Whatever is declared based on the hash tables, okay? You can get a particular value. You can get all the value. You can check whether your particular key is containing some what or your values is containing some what, right? You can get the value of key set only. You can get the value of values in different rows, right? You can get the values of key set and values, okay? In different row for in the same time, right? You can also get the size of the hash table, right? So how can I get it? SOISO, right? Each table dot size, okay? You can get it also, the size. Size will be 4 because I have added 4 different data type, right? 4 data combination, okay? So you can see, right? You can get the hash code, right? Okay, you can remove any element, you can update any element, right? You can get the set using the int set method, right? You can create another hash table where you can clone the data from the existing hash tables and you can print all the values, okay? You can get the size also. So that are the different methods or functions available in the collection framework. So thank you all for watching my videos. In case you are enjoying my videos and learning automation and testing in Java, please like and share my videos. Do not forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get notification as and when I will upload any new videos. Please provide your valuable comment for any input or suggestion. Stay tuned for my next video.